yes, that's sometimes a good thing in football.
First and goal from the 4. Hand the ball up to Kabongo again. This time he's met right in the middle by Dockett. And Tristan Francis finishes off the play. Second down.
Francis doing a much better job there of not giving up the edge, keeping his outside shoulder outside of Kabongo so he couldn't get outside of him, allows his help to come downhill as well as he teams up with Dockin on the tackle. That's some solid defensive football right there. Amonrud, Schaefer, and Cornelson from that inside spot.
Amonrud back to throw, trying to check this down. Oh, almost intercepted. And that's Colin Cornelson, and he's hitting the ground. The draft pick of the Winnipeg Blue Bombers trying to make a play. And going into the half, if you put that in the end zone, oh boy.
We almost had a big man touchdown. Cornelson, it was right there for you, buddy. Goodness me. I think our director, Rusty Cohn, could have caught this football and rumbled into the end zone. That was so close, man. You don't get those opportunities all the time.
Wow. It's back from their own 15-yard line. They'll hand the ball off to Riker Frank, who's met right at the line of scrimmage by Tristan Francis. And again, Manitoba forcing the Huskies into a second and long. Coaching the 3-minute warning. Riker Frank is in the backfield and he takes the first down carry. Makes one man miss. Brought down by Tristan Francis and Colin Cornelson. After a gain of just a yard. Here.
So we've got about a second, call it second and 7 here for the Thunderbirds. Rooker drops back, but a nice play. I think that was number 80 for the Bisons.
I got 90.
Pardon me, 90. Francis. Tristan Francis was able to get a big paw on that one and knock it away. So
Francis at the top of your screen here loops back into the middle right in the throwing lane and gets a paw on the short crosser. I don't know that that was going to go, and now there's no guarantee that they'll even get the chance to do that.
So 44-yard line here. Garrett Rooker, little inside handoff to Shamar McBean, but red excellent there by big Tristan Francis, and that's the second time we've called his name for a big play for this Manitoba defense.
Yeah, and this is some of that jet sweep action they were showing earlier. This time, though, Knight doesn't double back. He goes to lead block, but he runs right by Francis on the front side of this play, I think assuming, and sometimes that's the way you draw the scheme. You assume that your receiver, your fast athlete, can outrun the...
Very, very close. Very close. Hezekiah gets away with that one potentially there. Manitoba here looking to hold Regina. They got a 30 front. Nick Thomas on the spy there. Pressure coming and play. T. Jelly. Tristan Francis, the education student, the teacher, gets in there for the massive sack. Led the team with 2.5 sacks one season ago.
Not often do you see a defensive lineman leave his feet, put his arms up in the air, able to recover and get the sack on Sieben. Fantastic effort there from T. Jelly. Tristan Francis setting up a massive, massive play for his team, getting the ball back into Jackson Tijinsky's hands.
Breakout season for Francis last year. Kelvin High School product, went down to West Shore, played a little bit down there, actually played linebacker. Now back, and very important piece to this Manitoba Bisons defensive line.
Our shotgun formation with two backs. Handoff here to the short side. Tristan Francis plugs up the hole quickly there. Short gain for Calgary.
Yeah, as we see the tail end of the replay here, as Mike alluded to, Tristan Francis does a good job just wrapping up the Dinos running back after a short gain on first down, setting up second and medium here.
T. Jelly, they call him number 90. He's going to be a teacher when he's done his football career. This will be his last season with the Bisons as he's already doing his practicum here. He wants to be a teacher because he feels like there needs to be a little bit more of representation of black teachers in the classroom, and he wants to have the opportunity to be a part of that.
went on to make the playoffs. So for Manitoba to have that opportunity here today says a lot about how they've turned things around the last couple of weeks.
Erickson navigating his way through traffic for his best run of the opening quarter. Finally brought down by Tristan Francis, the fourth year Bison's defensive end.
Significant points. They should have, I'm sure they feel they should have more than six by now.
I'll hand the ball off to Erickson again. Right into the middle of that defense. Brought down by Tristan Francis again, who's racking up the tackles in the opening quarter.
At this point, you know they want six. They don't want to settle for a field goal try.
They'll put it on the ground to Savard again. And nowhere to go. Tristan Francis upended him, and then Jordan Friesen brought him down. So it will bring up third down on that between Mims and Stusik, the two leaders in your receiving corps. Just a touchdown reception each.
Yeah, that's not the kind of production you would have expected coming into this season, especially with some of the other weapons that the Regina Rams have. They need those veterans to really produce.
Sokol is the man in motion. They'll hand it off to Erickson. He cuts back to the middle, and nowhere to go. Tristan Francis wrapping up the running back.
Great play by Francis. Even if he didn't get the tackle there, he forced Erickson to cut back inside, but he still was able to get his big arm out and wrap him up. So here we go. This is...
So the game on the line here on third down. Steven bullets that in for Dallin Keene, who makes the catch. But he'll be 12 or 13 yards short of the first down, and it will be a turnover.
Backfield. Britton hands off to Sua on second down. He's going to fall forward near the 40-yard line, just shy. It's going to be
half. Rooker hands the football up tonight again, and he's met by Tristan Francis. Another stop from Manitoba this time on first down.
Francis might have lost the last snap, but he wasn't about to lose two in a row. Instant penetration into the backfield. Kills this play right away. Knight dropped for a loss. A handful of Manitoba Bisons there.
Caleb Mackey-McLeod was in the middle of that too. That if Begbie's in the backfield now, and Blake Neal called him a low ball, but it's play action. Rooker escapes the pressure. Now goes down. Tristan Francis gets to the quarterback. Manitoba will come up with a stop on second down. And a decision. And Blake Neal will elect to take the point.
Stevenson Bone goes aggressive here. The offensive coordinator calls a pass play on second and short. It looked like it was inside a yard there. Rooker tries to escape pressure a couple of times, but dragged